Magazine and formerly with the University of Alabama Press, where Fry Gilliard was one of our award-winning authors, one of our most sought-out authors as well. He's very popular on the speaking circuit. Actually, I don't think a year has passed where Fry has not won an award for his writing, and as a matter of fact, tonight he is being honored as a finalist for the Literary Artist of the Year from the Mobile Arts Council, but he chose to be here with us in Tuscaloosa instead. So thank you, Fry, for passing that up. Fry wrote this book called The Cradle of Freedom, and this was a pivotal book that explained the role Alabama as a state had in the civil rights movement. And from that, he actually won the coveted Lillian Smith Book Award. He also had a book called The Path of the Storm, and that was about Hurricane Katrina. And that was made into a documentary and won a regional Emmy. Another award that he received actually here on campus was the Clarence Cason Award. So he has a long list, but I decided not to spend 30 minutes listing all of those awards for you. Fry did start out as a journalist at the Charlotte Observer newspaper. He covered lots of wonderful events, such as Elvis's death, the Tammy Faye and Jim Baker story, if y'all remember them. And so he was very pivotal in lots of big moments that happened during that time period as a journalist. But it was when he was a teenager that he decided civil rights was important to him. And he was in Birmingham, and he could probably tell the story better than I, but when he was a young teenager in Birmingham, he saw this black man being arrested and taken away. And it was only later that he realized that black man being arrested was the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. So it was one of these pivotal moments in his life that made him realize that civil rights and injustice was something that he wanted to focus his career on. One of the reasons that we're here tonight is because of his book, which I have here, The Alabama Civil Rights Trail. And we've been using this book as kind of a guide for our own trail in Tuscaloosa. And some of the highlighted sections in this book for our area we're using to develop our own civil rights trail. And the book is important because it just doesn't cover everything that people know about, like the bombing of 16th Street Baptist Church or the marching across the Edmund Pettus Bridge in Selma, which this is the, when you ask people about Alabama civil rights, those are the two big things, the schoolhouse floor stand, of course, that's mentioned. But Fry also is able to find the stories of the people and the places, the events that a lot of us don't know about, even here in our own community. And so it's really important for us to highlight those, such as Linton's Barbershop. Anybody know about Linton's Barbershop in this room? Well, that's going to be part of our trail. Exactly. And that, there's only like five hands being raised, by the way. And the Bloody Tuesday event that occurred at First African Baptist Church, the foot soldiers that were important in that time. And there's a lot of events that we have very much a reason to be proud of, but no one knows these stories. And so that's why Fry is important to bring out these events and these places and help us to guide in our journey as we develop our own civil rights trail. And just a real quick note, when I was working at the University of Alabama Press and helped Fry promote this book, we did a bus tour. And some of you might remember that. We had this charter bus that said Civil Rights Tour along the side. We took some community members from Tuscaloosa and Birmingham, as well as some students from Stillman College. And Fry was the perfect tour guide as we went through Selma and Montgomery and Tuscaloosa and Birmingham. And I think one of the things that made the largest impact on me was after this tour, we had one of the students from Stillman College say, you know what, this has been very meaningful to me. I can read these accounts in a book, I can listen to my grandmother and granddaddy talk about it, and it goes in one ear and out the other. But when you have someone like Fry Gilliard, who is actually there at the place where it happened, and telling you the stories of what occurred, is more meaningful, it's much more powerful, and they remember it. And this student told me she was going to go back and change her major to history. I thought that was pretty powerful. And so I appreciate Fry for going on that bus tour and making a difference in one person's life. He made a difference in my life too, and probably more than just those, but that one young child, it made a huge difference in her life, and so I appreciate that about him. So it is now my distinct honor and pleasure to introduce to you one of my best friends, Fry Gilliard.